Hallo und herzlich willkommen zur weiteren Episode Danganronpa. Und jetzt gehen wir ans Ende dieser Hallway. Und wir finden... Oh, unser Pet. Was passiert mit ihm? Oh no. Okay. Ich würde das gerne öffnen. According to the map, Strawberry Tower is one... is on the other side of the door. There's a doorknob. There's no way we can open the door like this. Maybe you just have to press the button that's next to the door. You know, the one that has open written on it. I wonder what that means. It's funny, it's spelled just like the word open. Anyway, I just have to press the button then. Nekomaru raised his right arm and vigorously slammed the button more times than he needed to. So this is Strawberry Tower, huh? The building is shaped like a huge circle, plus the ceiling is so high I can't really make it out. Mouth these bright red decorations, what terrible taste. Well, with a name like Strawberry Tower, I guess the terrible decorations are intentional. That's right, this is Strawberry Tower, right? Then why do I see something that doesn't match the strawberry theme at all? There's a huge door at the far back of the tower, but there's a grave image on it. I thought this was Strawberry Tower. Wait, this image, it doesn't it match the one on the launch phone and also the one we found near the first elevator? Perhaps this door might be the exit. Huh? Exit? Take a look at the map we received from Monokuma.
I see.
There's a door at the far back of the Strawberry Tower, but nothing's drawn on the other side of that door. No, it doesn't mean... No, doesn't this mean that the exit is on the other side of the door? Therefore, we must try to confirm it by opening this door. Nekomaru let out a battle cry, grabbed the doorknob and tightly with both hands, and attempted to pry the door open. However... What does this mean? The doorknob won't budge, not even a bit. Is it locked? Well... Poop! It appears to be locked tight. In that case, I shall use my full power. With a fierce roar, Nekomaru put all his power into grabbing the doorknob with both hands, but... Not yet, here it comes, the incredible strength of 1,000,000 horsepower. Wait, isn't it creaking? If you break off the doorknob, we'll be stuck in here. That would be bad, so shouldn't we discuss this with everyone else first before you attempt to force your way through? You have a point. Very well then, even though the door would have opened soon, I would just give it rest. Then let's go back to Strawberries and discuss this with everyone. If they will listen to what I have to say, that is... Lieber, also dieses grape area wird vermutlich grün sein. Grün ist tausendmal besser als rot, ja? There's a picture on the floor. It's Usami's face. She has a strawberry in her mouth. Even this is strawberry themed, huh? Well, at least it's not an illustration of Monokuma. Ist das ein Grafikfehler oder warum ist das so rot da kurz ein bisschen? Is it just me or does it seem rowdy by the elevator over there? Did something happen? Oh, hi. Looks like everyone's causing a scene. Even Monokuma is here. Did something happen? How are you guys doing? Were you able to get a general idea of Strawberry House inside? Strawberry's house side? That's a strange thing to say. It sounds like there are another buildings. That's why there's a thing called contact elevator. Contact elevator, you say? Even though it's an elevator, it's a big mistake to think that it moves vertically. This is an elevator that travels along a rail, so even moving horizontally is easy as pie. Then does this elevator go to a different building? Yeah. That's right, to Grape House. Huh? Grape House? Hey, the fun house is an enormous building that's made out of other buildings. Well, we can worry about the details when you get to the Grape House. I will be going ahead. I don't really get it, but he just wanted to tell us to go to the Grape House this time, right? And that we must ride the elevator, right?
Are we screwed?
What should we do?
Show some spirit!
We just have to go for it. The only way we can overcome the situation is to make a move.
I mean...
But still, you know... What, you scared?
Of course not!
Hell no, why are you saying that in front of Misonia? Fine, I will go. I'm not scared at all. Well, I don't have it as bad as Katsuichi, but I do have a bad feeling about this, but we cannot just stand here and do nothing. Alright, let's go. When I pressed the grab button next to the door, it immediately opened. We stepped onto the elevator and off we went to the grape house. Is this already moving? If so, that would be awesome. I mean, it's not vibrating at all, right? This is probably a really high performance elevator if it's not vibrating all that much. Maybe it's not actually moving. Alright, let's open the door and make sure. You cannot, this is too dangerous. After staying inside the vibrating free elevator, eventually the door in front of us suddenly opened. It appears we arrived at our destination. Oh, tausendmal besser als rot. So this is Grape House. No matter where I look, everything is plastered with grape patterns. I was already fed up with strawberry patterns, but this is also unpleasant. Welcome to the Grape House. Now then, allow me to explain the Grape House. Ta-da! This is Grape House in its eternity. So let's start explaining the first floor. Aside from the fact that there is no final dead room, it's basically no different than Strawberry House. Just like how there's a strawberry hall over there, there's a grape hall on the side. And when you go through the grape hall, that means there's a grape tower. On the second floor of Grape House is the same as second floor of Strawberry House. I've prepared 5 guest rooms of different types along with a relaxing lounge, but the main attraction of Grape House is obviously the third floor. The Monokuma Archive. Everyone loves the Monokuma Archive. If you want to know about my proud accomplishments and contributes, feel free to study the literature there. Now then, this concludes the tour, but I believe it would be difficult to understand if I just explained with words. So you should all use your own feet to check out the inside of the building. That's all from me. Any questions? Like, I'm starting to get hungry. Where's the food anyway? Is that necessary? What are you saying? Of course it is. But it's supposed to be an escape game. So how can there be any tension if there's no limit? So I've decided to use the stomaches as the time limit. What do you mean? Well, simply put, it means kill someone before you starve to death. What the heck? If you're planning to kill someone, I highly recommend you make your kill as soon as possible. It will be too late if you get so weak you have no energy to kill. Hold on. Starve? How much more of this do we have to take until he's satisfied? Was he serious about there being no food? No way, that's the one thing I don't want. I don't mind starving as long as I can eat. Just let me eat already. As soon as she learned that there was no food, she was overcome by hunger. Obsession are truly annoying. But at least try to stay calm. Now it's not the time for you to panic. Well, being loud here isn't gonna help us, so for now we should explore the inside of the building too. After all, if you don't give up, you're sure to find hope. Isn't that right for you, Hiko? That's right. Then let's get started. The same pairing as before is fine, right?
Hey.
Hold on. This time around, I really want to pair up with Misonia. She's already left with Gundam. Looks like you're being avoided, not just rejected.
Hey.
Katsuichi, I understand that you're feeling down, but we better get going.
Damn right.
Akane, you too. How much longer are you going to stay shocked? Come on, let's go. With heavy steps, everyone left to explore Grape House. Now then, where should we start? Since we're on the first floor, it might be okay if we start with Grape Tower. So you're saying we're going to start with the most suspicious place. Alright, then let's start with Grape Tower. Also zu trinken hätten wir schon mal, ne? Anyway, let's find the exit. Damn it, there's no way I'm going to let myself starve to death in here. Also. Zu trinken gibt's auf jeden Fall, weil Badezimmer. Hogger. That's a big oof. Aber gut zu wissen. Also auf jeden Fall würde ich das Grape House wählen gegenüber dem Strawberry House. Wenn man sich eins aussuchen müsste. Okay, Nicomara raised his voice and vigorously slammed the button more times than he needed to. It's not opening. That's weird. When we are at Strawberry Hall, this should have opened. Don't tell me it's out of order. Fine. Fine time for it to break down. Well, it obviously shouldn't. Did you hear something? And that's when Nicomara started shouting. The door opened, but what was that pause just now? Why didn't the door open right away? So this is Grape Tower. The structure of this building doesn't seem all that different compared to Strawberry Tower. Yeah, right. The building is the same circular shape and the ceiling is just as high and hard to make out. However, this wall is green. Strawberry Tower wall is red. Well, speaking of differences, there should be something balancedly different over there. There's a picture on the floor of Usami's face with grapes in her mouth. This feels different from Strawberry Tower. The Usami picture over there has a strawberry in her mouth. But what's truly different? Yeah, das hat jetzt da die Tür. Also, on the Grape Tower door at the far back, there's a strawberry image in there. A strawberry door inside Grape Tower. That sounds complicated. It's like the opposite of Strawberry Tower. As I recall, there should have been a grape image on the far back of the Strawberry Tower. So on the strawberry side there's a grape door, on the grape side is a strawberry door. That's even more complicated. Nein, es bedeutet einfach, dass die Räume geswitcht werden, je nachdem, auf welchen Knopf man drückt. However, this time this door might connect to the outside.
I see.
It's obviously by looking at this map, since there's nothing beyond the far back of the door of Grape House. If so, the only thing we can do is to try. I heard what you guys were discussing, but it would be pointless to even try, I think. What did you say? Before we get to that, why are you here, Chiaki? Won't you go with Nagito and Katsuichi? It's exhausting to be around those two. So you ran away. Oh, sie ist zu mir zurückgekommen. That door doesn't lead outside. I think it's pointless to even try it out. Definitely. Definitely, you say. It's rare for Chiaki to be that certain. I have a good reason for that. I think I found out the secret of Funhouse structure. The secret.
Want me to tell you?
Want me to tell you? Do you want me to explain it to you? Well, pay close attention to each house relationship to its respective tower.
Hey, hey.
First, try to remember the first floor of Strawberry House. From the elevator, Strawberry Hall is on your left-hand side, right? And if you walk along it, you will end up at Strawberry Tower, right?
See?
On the other hand, Grape House. From the elevator, Grape Hall is your right-hand side, right? And if you walk along it, you will end up at Grape Tower. Now, here comes the main point with those two types of buildings.
Whoa.
And so we're here all along. Hey, Jackie, don't go off running on your own. You disappeared so suddenly, I was worried about you. Katsuichi, Nagito.
You.
Thanks to your disappearance, I was left alone with Nagito. Was that annoying for you?
Right.
Hell yeah, it was. I don't want to be alone with a creep like you.
This is
I see, so it's not just Hajime. You don't trust me either, hmm?
Hey.
Katsuichi, hey, are you okay? Have you stopped trusting other humans?
Shut up!
Well, yeah, thanks to you. Oh, you all came. Good timing, we didn't have to waste any time gathering people. That was quick, I thought your investigations would take more time.
Oh yeah.
There aren't many areas to search and we didn't find any good clues. Right now, the only thing I found out is there's seriously no food anywhere. This ain't funny at all. I hear that it's super painful to die from starvation. Before that happens, why don't we, you know, the hamsters that Gundam carries around. What are you implying? I'm sorry. Katsuichi, you should be grateful to Sonia. If you would gotten your hands on my four dark devious of destruction, your body would be incinerated by hellfire. But are the hamsters going to be okay without food? Fortunately, the flowers blooming in Strawberry House Indoor Park are cursed flowers from Hell's Garden. As long as those seeds are there, the fall duct devious of destruction shall not lose a single hit point. I'm relieved to hear that. Die können die Blumen doch essen. Now then, let's listen to your reports and see what you guys have found. Personally, I would rather let Chiaki continue your talk, but I should listen to what everyone has to say. Now then. Is it fine if Gundam, Fuyuhiko and I represent our teams and give the reports?
Damn right.
Yeah, I don't mind. We Joyce Mongrels have discovered something that you fiends will be happy to hear about. Yes, our team's discovery is number one. We shall not lose. I think your priorities are off. Wäre ein Kampf nicht um sogar Food viel besser? Ach, keine Ahnung. Fangen wir an hier mit Fuyuhiko. Du hast die beste Character Development. I'm sure the others already know, but let me tell you in this case. The second floor of Grape House also has a guest room similar to the ones on the second floor of Strawberry House. But instead of being covered with strawberry patterns, they are covered with grape patterns. Das ist tausendmal besser. Also like the guest room, there's a similar lounge here as well. There's also a phone in the lounge too. However, instead of the grape button that was on the phone in Strawberry House lounge, there's a strawberry button on the phone in the Grapes House lounge.
Now then.
I'm just guessing at this point, but it's possible that we can use those two phones to communicate with each other.
For sure.
So the picture on the button shows where each phone connects to. The pictures on the button shows where each phone connects to. That's probably it. Yeah, it's halt oof. Achso, Moment, die haben nichts Neues herausgefunden. Gundam, du hast was herausgefunden. Now then, I shall present to you my discovery. I won't let you say such nonsense like I forgot. Monokuma said it himself before we arrived. He said that there are shepherds in the funhouse. Could it be Katsuichi and you lowly humans? Fall to your knees and show your gratitude to me, the Overlord of ice of the destroyed world of death. Feast your eyes on this. Behold, Immortal, it's a ship part. Based on its extremely small size, isn't that? That's a radio controlled toy. Allow me to tell you a little old story. I was born as a result of a union between a human and a demon, and my existence was shunned by both races. Perhaps it's because nobody was ever brought to me a toy before, but I believe this is truly remarkable.
Shut up.
I'm not asking about that. You mean the ship part you found was just some radio-controlled toy?
Loser!
You totally got tricked! I never said a single word about the ship being real, stupid idiot moron. Looks like we don't even have the strength to get upset. It might be better if we leave him alone for a while. So it was definitely a waste of time to believe Monokuma. If so, what he said about our student profiles might be a lie too. But our situation is getting so grim that I can't really focus on that right now. Oh, hätte ich mir alle auf mich gehört, ne? Ohne Spaß. Und einfach leben, ne? Und haben uns überlegt. Die hätten dann im Pool schwimmen können, immer richtig schön essen können. Jackie hätte die ganze Zeit spielen können. Allow me to give you a brief report. Since I'm the one who made this discovery, it's just as important as I am. Which means it's nothing important at all. Hurry up and say it already. Well, it's about the third floor of the Grape House.
See?
Do you remember what Monokuma said about a Monokuma archive on the third floor? I actually tried to get there.
Jeez.
Like the name suggests, it was an archive full of stuff about Monokuma. It reminded me of those celebrities who built their memorial house in their hometown. Then it looks like we don't ever need to go in there ever. I also found a lost child at the Monokuma archive. A lost child? Where did she go?
Hey!
Don't just hide, come out. Hello. So the lost child was you. That's how people react, right? Well, I had a general idea of how you all would react. It's okay. I won't be depressed anymore. I'm used to being treated so poorly. All sad. It's so sad to get used to it. She seems a little tense. Did Monokuma bring you here as well, Monomi? Yes, I'm so ashamed of myself for getting carelessly tricked by him. I'm a failure as a teacher. I have no right to guide everyone. Nobody here considers you a teacher to begin with. But I'm honestly happy that you're here. Huh? You're a complete stuffed animal. Is there any part of you left that's still rabbit meat? I'm expected to be food?
Hey, hey.
That was the last report, right? Then it... Is it okay if we go now? This is what you mentioned earlier, right? About the structure of the funhouse. Then the structure of the funhouse? Well, I've come to a conclusion. The grape tower that we are currently in and the strawberry tower we were in earlier are the same room. I think they're actually the same building. The two towers are the same building, you say? I see. What makes you think that? Their positions. Inside the strawberry house, strawberry hall is on your left, when your back is facing the elevator, right? But inside the grape house, the grape hall is on your right, when your back is facing the elevator, right? And so, if we think about it and put those two together... Was ist, wenn jetzt der ultimative Prank ist und das rechte eigentlich ganz links ist? The two towers are the same building and each house connects to the center. That's the building structure that comes to mind. Muss noch nicht fertig sein. What, Strawberry Tower and Grape Tower are the same building? But that might be a possibility. Come on, take a look at that door. Isn't that strawberry image the same one that's on the elevator and the telephone? Then it's the same way. Wouldn't that imagine on the door also be showing where it leads to? If that's the case, it would mean that strawberry house is beyond that door with a strawberry image on it. As well as the opposite, the grape door that was at the strawberry tower would lead to grape house, meaning we opened the grape hall's door when we came in here. Meaning, depending on which door we use, this tower changed to either strawberry tower or grape tower. Which means, when you look at the other side of the grape hall door that was used to come in here...
Yep,
the grape picture should actually be on here. Then we all gotta do is confirm it, right? If we can't close that door from the other side. That might be impossible. Possible why? Well, Hajime and Ikumaru were the first ones to enter grape tower, right? What's wrong with that? When you two entered grape tower from grape hall, didn't it take a little while for the door to open after you press the button? So just as I assumed. When I was walking around myself, I went back to the strawberry house for a while. I felt like there was still something I missed when suddenly the strawberry hall door automatically closed in front of me. The door automatically closed? And afterward, no matter how much I pressed the button, the strawberry hall wouldn't open. But why? The doors to Strawberry Tower and Grape Tower must have been designed so that only one can open at the time. I mean, if both doors open at the same time, we would easily find out that both towers are the same building. If that happens, it wouldn't be a funhouse anymore, right? Then the reason the Strawberry Hall door is automatically closed in front of you, was it because we opened the Grape Hall door? When that happened, the grape hall didn't open because it was waiting for strawberry hall's door to close. If you think about it like that, it makes sense, right? You're saying all this hard stuff I don't get, but aren't you forgetting the most basic problem? The color of the walls in Strawberry Tower and Grape Tower are different, you know? There's no way they are the same building.
Don't know.
You didn't notice? They are just lights on the floor being shined on the wall by reflecting a colored light onto a white wall. It makes it look like the wall color has changed. Then what about the picture on the floor? Is that different too? Maybe the floor is just a screen and the picture is being projected from beneath the floor. In fact, when you look at it closely, it's not a picture that was actually drawn onto the floor. I see, then it's safe to say they are the same building, right? But this is a very important problem, so isn't it better if we test it out? Test? Genau, das wollte ich vorschlagen. Is it better if we leave something behind here and we all go to Strawberry Tower? Right. And if it's still there, we can conclude that they are the same building, right? Want me to stay then? Keine Person. No, that's impossible. There's a sensor preventing that. Sensor? Don't you feel it? There are countless sensors plastered all over the tower's walls and floor. Why can't you notice them? I am more surprised that you actually notice them. My guess is that my sensor can probably detect any movement within the tower. When it reacts, it prevents the door from opening. I know there at least be something like that. By the way, how good is that sensor performance? It's quite high performance. It seems that I can even detect your heartbeats and breathing patterns. Then it would be completely impossible for someone to stay behind. What about Ikumari? He's a heartless robot. I have a monitor running inside me as good as any human heart. But if you're in sleep mode, that function will come to a stop, right? Like you said, if I cease all functions with sleep mode, the sensor won't detect it, but... Do you need to go that far to test it? I won't tolerate any robot prejuices. Prejustice. Sorry, you're right. And once I enter sleep mode, I will not regain consciousness until the good night switch is pressed again, or if my chest alarm goes off. I'm a little concerned about being left alone in that state. It is far too dangerous, even as an experiment. It is possible that we might violate the law of robotics. Then why don't we just use this? My student handbook. I will leave this handbook here and we all move over to Strawberry Tower. And if by any chance the handbook is still there, we can safely say that the towers are the same, right? You're right, let's try this. Darf man?
I see.
I must say this elevator is rather quiet. It is like the Toad's Ward. Oh wait, never mind. Toad's Ward? What is she talking about? It doesn't feel like we are moving extremely fast. It seems it's moving very slowly. If so, the two houses might be surprisingly close. If two towers are connected in the middle, the distance between them shouldn't be that much. Alright, let's over to the Strawberry Tower. If I press the button, then I will press it. Wait, step aside, you fiends. What? A misery of evil. In accordance with our ancient contracts, the time has come to lend me your aid.
By four dark devils of destruction.
Ah, I've pressed the button. Truly, this is the skyline lamentations art of the demon mouse. Soon the door of destiny shall open. Amazing, your hamsters are truly skilled. I see your eyes manage to follow sense these movements as expected of the dark lady. You have my praise. Oh my god, die kommen together oder scheinen jetzt irgendwie am prickeln zu sein und ich kenne ja jemanden, ihm gefällt das gar nicht. Truly amazing, you must have a strong, trusting relationship with them. Thank you. Pff, you didn't need to bother making your hamster present. Just as I thought, it's taking a while to open. Considering what we discussed earlier, the sensor will confirm that nothing is moving inside the tower, then wait for the other door to close. At that moment, I heard a loud sound from the other side of the door. Oh, look over there. The moment we set foot inside Strawberry Tower, Sonya raised her voice. When I looked where she was pointing, it's there, the handbook.
Yep,
there's no doubt this is my student handbook. If the handbook Chiaki left in Grape Tower is here, that means it seems that we confirmed it.
Yep.
Strawberry Tower and Grape Tower are actually the same building, and depending on whatever you enter from Strawberry Hall or Grape Hall, the tower becomes either Strawberry Tower or Grape Tower. Okay, verständlich. Then that door over there with the grape image on it.
I see.
It's not the exit, but it appears it's connected to Grape House Grape Hall.
This is troubling.
But it also means that we have no idea where the exit is. Well, I guess that can't be helped. There's no way we'd actually find the exit that easily. Well, anyway, I'm surprised. I can't believe you already uncovered the secret like this. As expected of Chiaki, you're truly amazing. Normally, all you do is stare into space, but at times like this, you really pull through for us. Nagito? However, why was this building designed so strangely?
So
there's probably no reason, it's simply because it's a fan house. That's all the reason Monokuma needs. Where are you again?
What?
I'm Monomi, why did you forget about me? That reminds me, whatever happened to the Monokuma announcement?
Huh?
What do you mean? According to my internal clock, it's already past 10 PM.
Oh,
is that time already? Despite that, why hasn't there been a Monokuma announcement? Allow me to answer. Every single day up until now, I have consistently let you know when it's morning night on the island. And thanks to that, you have been able to live a normal life. Why do you guys... Did you guys mistake me for some kind of pretty alarm clock? Ah, well, it's truly true that I'm pretty, but... Hey, what are you trying to say? For the time being, the Monokuma announcements are on hiatus. You can't go outside and there are no windows here, so it's not like it matters if it's morning or night. Also, I've been thinking of a little something to replace the Monokuma announcement.
I don't like
what's
this.
Wrong with him? Well, if there's no announcements, we can just look at the clock. Both Strawberry House and Grape House have clocks in their first floor lounges. Even if I don't look at the clock, I have my internal clock, so it's no problem for me anyway. And it's already past 10 PM, right? I'm starting to feel sleepy after hearing that. Since we don't have food, it might be better if we rest and conserve our energy. For now, let's just decide our room assignments. Room assignments? Each house has 5 guest rooms, so we should first decide who's gonna stay in which house. Why don't we make things simple and split them between the boys and the girls?
Yes,
let us do that. That's a bummer, but well, I guess it makes sense. Then ladies first. Now then, kittens, choose which house you would like. Let's just choose the grape house. Starting at red room is just going to strain my eyes. Das ist es nämlich. Then the man shall have the strawberry house. Strawberry men are known for passions. Also, each house had guest room of varied quality, right? Wasn't it 2 deluxe rooms, 1 standard room and 2 crummy rooms?
For now.
And we need to decide those next, huh? But there are only 5 rooms in each house, right? Then one guy will be left over. Then that means there's only one appropriate way to settle this. Rock, paper, scissor, of course. Suddenly the rock, paper, scissor battle between 6 guys had begun. And the results? Ah, sorry, I ended up winning so easily. Ah, yeah, ultimate luck. That's right, I totally forgot that Nagito is the ultimate lucky student. So I take second place, that's fine, I was getting bored of always being on top. It's decided, you two will get a deluxe room. Then regarding the third winner, it's me, I will rest in the standard room.
Right.
Me and Kotsuichi are next.
Man.
So I get a crummy room, well, it's better than rooming with someone. That's unfortunate, Hajime, you can rest in the lounge, but try not to catch a cold.
Hey,
how about you Grape House girls? Did you all pick your rooms as well? Yeah, we did. We had a brief discussion and settled things smoothly. Sonya and I have the deluxe room, and apparently Akane wants one of the crumsy rooms. Why did you choose the crumsy room? There's still a standard room left over.
Like
it's good enough for me. You guys might think it's pretty creepy, but it's a place compared to my home. So there's a standard room and a crumsy room left. Hajime, if you would like, please use one of them. Huh? You can't do that.
Oh my.
Why not?
Well,
I mean, it's dangerous. Hajime might be the traitor, you know. What are you saying?
Miss Sonya?
What am I, huh?
Sonya.
We haven't doubted Hajime at all.
Like,
even I don't think he would try to trigger us. It seems that you are the only one who thought Hajime is suspicious. Really? Of all people, you're gonna say that? You're really gonna say that?
Right?
Hajime, you can use one of the leftover rooms. Thank you. I will feel bad about using the standard room, so I would stay in the clumsy room. But even so, it really helps that I have a place to sleep. Now then, it's decided we should turn off it in for today. It's like it doesn't make any sense. And so all the guys except for me ended up staying the night on the second floor of Strawberry House, and all the girls plus my leftover self stayed on the second floor of Grape House. Jeez, just as I thought, I was forgotten. Well, I'm used to it after all. Dann nimmt sie den Standardraum oder was? So this is the second floor of the Grape House. Choosing Grape House was definitely a good decision. Yeah, what do you mean? You see, Strawberry House is a quadrilateral, but Grape House is hexagonal. That means this place is far more spacious. It is quite a good bargain. For a princess, you sure do think about pretty stuff. The deluxe rooms are two rooms at the far back, right? So it's okay if we already go? The two rooms at the front are the crappy rooms, right? Hajime, you use the room next to the lounge. So the standard room across from the lounge will remain unoccupied. I should prepare nameplates for our rooms later. I shall also include portraits of everyone's faces. You don't really need to draw our faces, but the nameplates might be a good idea. Then good night. After reaching the limits of her sleepiness, Chiaki staggered over to her deluxe room. Now then, I shall retire for the evening as well. Good night, everyone. Good night, see you tomorrow. After exchanging good nights, everyone went to their guest rooms. I should get some sleep too. I think I was assigned to the crummy room that's next to the lounge. Ja, nur ein bisschen checken hier, ne? Nicht, dass ich... Warum keep out? Okay, komisch. This is a surprisingly shabby guest room. It's a little cold in here. The draft coming from the door is making me hungry. But I shouldn't be talking like that. For now, I need to endure it no matter what. No matter what happens, I will definitely prevent a killing from happening. I won't let Monokuma get what he wants. Ist das Blindenschrift? Kann es jemand übersetzen? Oh, Morse code. This concludes the Monokuma Theater Morse code edition. Kannst du jemand die Mühe? Ach, keine Ahnung, ich schau das irgendwann mal nach. It's morning already. Now that there are no Monokuma announcements, I don't feel like my usual safe anymore. There should be a clock in the launch. I should head over there and see what time it is. ...9 AM. It's later than I'm used to waking up, but I guess it still counts as morning. Now then, what should I do now? In this kind of situation, panicking will accomplish nothing. Might be better if I spend time like I normally do as long as I can. I should find someone to talk to, or might be a good idea just to stay in my room and conserve my energy. Okay, free time haben wir jetzt. Ihr wisst, wo wir als allererstes hingehen. Wir müssen uns um unsere Waifu kümmern. Yes. Jetzt sagt nicht, sie ist noch am Pennen. Wahrscheinlich, oder? Is Chiaki still sleeping? Sorry, I'm thinking about stuff. Let's play after we get out of here. Keiner will mit uns irgendwas machen. Warum ist er überall keep out? Ich würde gerne mal runtergehen in den Shop von Monokuma und ich möchte das Ding noch holen. Ah ne, ich muss nach oben, genau. Hm. Okay. So this is a Monokuma archive that Nagito was telling me about. Apparently there are no clues that might be useful for escaping this place, but in the future they might be necessary to know about the enemy. God, that gives up a feel. Okay, da ist keiner hinter, ich dachte gerade. Oder? Dahinter steht doch einer.
Are you serious?
Mal gerade sagen. Ah, so muss ich gucken. Despair Boys. Hola, crap. Okay, seine Spielzeuge. Nupio. Aus dem Monokuma Theater, lol. Live Game. So, und ich möchte gerne zurück. Also, so, das heißt, ich muss, um auf eine andere Seite zu kommen, den Elevator nutzen. Das steht schon mal fest. This is the door. It has much different ambience compared to everything else. According to Monokami, if you win the life-threatening game that takes place inside this room, you'll be able to reach the octagon where the ultimate weapon is waiting, supposedly. Okay. Jetzt kann ich den noch endlich mal erholen. Oh, ich scheine alle gefunden zu haben. Nice. Ja, komm, Nagito.
Hello there.
Ah, welcome, Hajime. What are you welcoming me for? It's probably because you're staying at Grape House. For some reason, you seem like a guest. If I offend you at all, I apologize. No, there's no need to apologize. Oh, yeah, while we're at it, I should let you know our room assignment. The deluxe room at the back toward the lounge area is my room. Across from that is Gundam's room. So yeah, okay. Of course, we are using the portrait Sonya drew in place of name plates on our doors. So even if you don't remember, it will be okay as long as you use that sign. I didn't know that she drew portraits for the guys, for a princess Sonya is very diligent. Drawing a portrait of a lowly human like Great. Me. I might drown from such undeserved honor. Sonya's merciful heart might be ultimate level too. Even in this situation, he still acts like this. Wollen wir jetzt irgendwie abhängen? Ach komm.
Yep.
Yeah, I don't mind. There's plenty of time today. I spent time with Nagito today talking about various things. I guess Nagito and I drew a little closer today. Will you guys get present? Ja, klar. Was haben wir denn so, was keine Sau braucht? Das sind vermutlich Key-Items. Well, das hätte mal... Der freut sich doch bestimmt über alles, oder? Also können wir ihm auch hier so irgendwie Crap-Zeug geben.
Huh?
Can I have this? It's really generous of you to give a gift to a piece of trash like me. There should be a time for me to move around more freely. Sorry, I'm thinking about stuff. Let's play after we get out of here. Können wir was mit Gundam machen? Alte Haudegen, ja. Oh, for Yuhiko. Na komm. Weil du dich so gut verbesserst. What happened, Hajime? Don't waste your energy wandering around. What should I do?
Damn right.
Well, I guess it's not so bad talking to you once in a while. I spent time today talking to Fuyoka about various things. Looks like in Fuyoka and I grew a little closer. Energy drink for dich. Are you giving that
Damn
to me?
Right.
I guess I will take it off your hands for now. Hey Fuyoko, how's that wound on your stomach doing? It's fine, nothing to worry about. I thought you would say that. You must have abnormally strong willpower to actually slice open your own stomach like that. Then again, you are the ultimate Yakuza. I just have Yakuza blood flowing in my veins. There's nothing strong about that. You know, I did some thinking about this when I was in the hospital. Maybe this is all a dream. A dream, huh? How great would that be? I'm sorry, you obviously would be thinking about that more than I would. That's not true. I've seen plenty of people die up till now. And as long as I'm burdened with the Kozuyo name, I will always be dealing with a mountain of bodies. But you guys aren't like me. It's a side joke to see students who live honest live bumping each other off like this. This guy has always known violence and death. I see he used to it. Are you scared to talk to me? Huh?
Jeez.
There's no need to hide it. I'm used to being treated with caution by everyone. The world is a barbaric place, especially in my world. Everyone I know tries to settle things with violence. You guys have different values than I do. My old man likes to say predators are always stronger than their prey. He's a hothead. Even if it's just a minor argument, he will come out with everything he's got. And when him and my mom fight, she seriously tries to kill him. Being Yakuza means you can even kill the man you love to get your point across. I've been hearing stuff like that since before I was old enough to understand what's going on around me. That's pretty outrageous home life. The worlds we both live in couldn't be more different. There were a few times where I nearly got killed in the aftermath of my parents' fights. But whenever something like that happened, Pico was always there by my side. I'm sorry, I made you remember something painful. What? You don't need to apologize for that, you strange bee. But still, I'm the rightful successor of the Kozuyo clan and don't get overwhelmed where we use you. By the time I was in the second grade, I didn't cry even if I lost the fight. I see, good for you.
Bastard.
Good for me, don't treat me like a kid. I don't really know what else to say to him. Anyway, it's not much, but I'm starting to get to know Fuyuki a little better. After talking to Fuyuki about some other things, I parted ways with him and to return to my home. There should be time for me to move around more freely. Noch mehr Zeit, ui. Die wollen halt echt, dass ich hier noch. Sorry, I'm thinking about stuff. Let's play after we get out of here. Können wir mal mit Gundam reden? Auch wenn er vermutlich von Katsuichi gekillt wird. Nice.
Let me tell you.
Heed my warning, beware the Dark Queen, it seems your true power has not awakened yet. Oops, I've said too much. What should I do? Yeah. Okay, there's no need to be that afraid. I doubt she would awaken immediately. Even now, the Dark Queen's power is still struggling against the abyss that consumes the darkness. Gonna continue to talk about his fantasized version of Sonya that he made up on his own. Looks like Gundam and I grew a little closer. Would you like a present? Yes. Der mag doch bestimmt sowas wie irgendwas mit Ach zu trinken. Komm hier. Do you really think I would be happy with something like this? Fine, I guess I will accept it for the time being. You should prepare a better offering next time. Don't get any closer, I already know what you're thinking. What do you know that I even don't know? Now then, summon your familiar. No, I don't have anything like that. You've come challenging me many times. I thought you finally obtained at least one familiar. Just as I thought. You're just a mere human and a strange on one of that. Despite what he's saying, Gunnar doesn't seem all that annoyed. Is he opening up to me a little? However, you probably don't understand how pointless this place is for a demon beast tainer. Now that you mention it, even though this is a tropical island, I don't really see any wild animals. If this place really has a normal tropical island, I wouldn't have time to talk to you so freely. Many beasts inhabit the thick forest. There may even be rare species that only exist in this island. Just thinking about it makes me tingle. He's smiling right now. Ah, I seem to recall seeing a cow at the ranch. I'm not interested in some domesticated animal. Wollte ich gerade sagen, da waren auch Kühe und so. I had a feeling you would say that. After all, I cannot look at it without feeling pity. Huh? That's a bit unaccepted. Such creatures are born to be eaten by humans. Even if I had all-seeing eye, I couldn't change that fate. Thus, I try not to involve myself with livestock. It would bring a calamity onto my mind after all. Gunnar understands the feelings of animals, so this must be a complicated subject for him. I appear to be getting oddly sentimental since I haven't encountered any new demon beasts. I've tamed various creatures such as the Caribus, the Phoenix and even the Migrat Serpent. He probably means dog, birds and lizards. When he said tamed, what exactly does that entail? I guess it's fine to tell a mere human, I don't believe that you will get in my way. Basically, you must say, good girl, huh? You must repeatedly speak to them and make sure they understand that there is no ill will in our end. In order to do that, you need to appear innocent. Of course, there are some who like to be touched and some that don't. It's better if you keep these basics down. Afterwards, as long as you spend a long time together, you will eventually start to hear partner's words. I'm pretty sure that only happens to ultimate breeders, but Gundam seems different from usual when he talks about animals. Somehow his face seems gentler. He must really love animals. Now then, I wonder if there are evil demon beasts that will rile me up on this island somewhere. Monokuma and Muni are sort of shaped like animals. They are no good. Anything that can talk will eventually betray you. And most importantly, they aren't cute. I agree. But I don't plan to betray you at all. Such exaggeration coming from a mere human like you. However, that's a nice line. Gundam left the area with a different smile on his face than usual. I hope he will be able to understand each other, even if it's just a little bit at a time. After seeing Gundam walk away, I left the area. What time is it right now? It's already 10 PM, just as I thought. I can't get a sense of what time it is when there are no windows or Monokuma's announcements. It is still a little early, but I should go back to my room. I'm trying to do my very best not to worry, but even I have limits. I'm hungry. Oops, I hear that. Jeez, are you running already? It's only your second day. It's so jeez of you to do this that all I can say is jeez. You should just stop being stubborn. Hurry up and start the killing already. What do you want? My, my, you don't even have the energy to be mad, huh? Well, I have good news for you guys. You've all lost your drive ever since you guys got here, right? You have the drive of an old man in his 50s. In order for you guys to get your energy back, I'm providing a special service with all my heart. So everyone please gather at Grip Tower tomorrow morning at 7 a.m. 7 in the morning? There's no alarm clock in this room. How do you expect us to wake up? That's your responsibility, so you figure out. By the way, being late is strictly prohibited. Okay then, goodbye. So with all your hearts, huh? It's no use, my stomach feels so empty, I can't stop thinking about food. If I know Monokuma, there's no way he will provide that for us. Damn it. I pulled over the thin covers of my futon, desperately trying to ignore my hunger pangs, and went to sleep. Ja, wie willst du jetzt verhindern, dass du... verschläfst? Today I interviewed random strangers on the street and asked them, what do you hate about Monokuma? Here are the results. He has a full mouth, a terrible personality, and he's a rude pig, but he's still popular despite all that. He's a lazy ass who doesn't work hard at all, and yet he's more skilled and better than people who do. Not only did God give him both hands, God gave him everything. He always talks crap about others, but nobody really talks crap about him. That he's willing to die to protect the woman he loves. That he can't live without me. He's usually cold toward me, but he takes good care of me when I'm sick. He always slaps me around when he drinks, but afterward, he cries and gently hugs me. I hate that his job changes every time he gets a new job. He's extremely responsive when the other people say things like drinks, group dates, and promotions. I hate that my daughter suddenly got curvier after she enrolled in middle school. Those were the results. Oh, I'm so loved. I don't think I will belong to one person for a while. What? I'm starting to feel the strange chill. Well, it obviously must be from hunger. Wait, what time is it now? I stepped up much slower than usual, then headed straight to the launch. Hmm? 6:30 a.m. It's a miracle I was able to wake up. As I recall, it's bad if we don't gather at Grape Tower by 7 a.m. I don't expect much from Monokuma, but I guess I should go for now. ich muss nach... Für den Tower? Muss ich nach unten. Ich wollte was lösen, ohne nachzugucken. Everyone who gathered here had pale faces. Lass mich raten, manche sind gar nicht pennen gegangen. I'm seriously so tired. Stop complaining, you are bringing me down. But I'm exhausted. Not only can we not eat, but we are being forced to come here early in the morning. This isn't about just you. We are all getting screwed here. But we are getting screwed the most. Obviously, we are more tired than everyone else. I mean, we had to take the contact elevator to get here from Strawberry House. So we had to walk all the way from Strawberry Hall to the elevator and then walk all the way over here. The longer you walk, the more calories you burn. So obviously we are more tired than you guys. Stop whining. You're fine. You don't have to worry about getting hungry since you're a robot. I'm in a similar situation. I have my charger inside my cottage. Man, you guys are already starting to brag about how unhealthy you are. I've got a lot of nerve coming here. Now that we all have gathered here so quickly in the morning, what do you intend to make us do this time?
No, no.
I just want everyone to be healthy again. Healthy.
Hey, hey.
You're losing your drive because you're burning rubber down the unhealthy highway, right? I'm offering this service so that you can feel all healthy again, so... From this day forward, I would like to make Monokuma Tai Chi part of your daily routine every morning. Tai Chi? Alright, start the music.
To make optimal use of Earth's gravity and release yourself from the tension of your conscious self. Control your breathing slowly and softly. Move as if you're drawing a circle. Naturally, just as you are. Relax your body and mind.
This is clearly affecting my hunger. Why do I exactly have to do this? We sure worked up a good sweat. Staying healthy is definitely super important. Oh fuck, oh, why did a bunch of pointless exercise thanks to you? Now we're hungrier than ever. I can't move. The road to good health is not an easy one. It might be painful, but we will do this again tomorrow. Unless something big happens, I won't allow any tardiness or absences. Make sure you remember that. You intend to keep making us do this? Guys, I don't think I'm gonna last till tomorrow. And not already, how much longer is this going to last?
This is troubling.
Didn't he say until the killing starts? It seems the possibility of those words is finally starting to affect us. If this persists any longer, it wouldn't surprise me if something really did happen. I don't wanna die in a place like this. If I'm gonna die in a place like this, I might as well. What are you saying? I can't fucking calm down. There's no food, there's no way to escape. If this goes on, Eri's gonna starve to death. Are you telling us to just wait until we starve to death? I would rather have that happen to us than have our friends kill each other. Do you mean that you would rather die? I got it. You're just saying that because you're the traitor. What? You're planning to make us all weak so you can kill us all. What are you saying? Fizz up, you've been secretly getting food from your future foundation buddies, haven't you? I swear you better.
So
making a scene is just going to make us hungrier, so let's just calm down for now. You're right, even if you guys fight, our situation isn't going to change. Wait to die from impending starvation or wait for someone to kill someone else before that happens. At any rate, it's a rather difficult situation. Which is the true hope. I will just follow what everyone else decides. If you're going to choose, you should hurry. The longer we keep waiting, the closer we get to death. The conversation ended there. It seems nobody has had the energy to keep talking, haggering, so we silently left Grape Tower. I'm just standing, but I feel dizzy. My sense of balance is off. It's like I'm in a rocking boat or something. That doesn't mean I should stay put. If I just leave this matter alone, something bad might happen. It's not like I'm worried, but I should go see how everyone is doing. Okay. Oof, die Musik. Wenn es euch gefallen hat, schreibt mir in die Kommentare, wer denkt, ihr wird wen umbringen. Also ich tippe auf Katsuichi, bringt Gundam um, Pock. In diesem Sinne bedanke ich mich ganz herzlich fürs Zusehen und wir sehen uns in der nächsten Episode. Bis dann. Tschüss.